Hello, I'm Jonathan Simon with the Google Cloud Platform team. I'm going to talk to you about Google Cloud Storage and how you can use JavaScript to start building on top of Google's powerful storage infrastructure. Cloud Storage is a fast, scalable, and reliable storage service offered by Google as part of its cloud platform. For more details about Cloud Storage, here are two links to help you get started. I'm going to show you a demo of a cloud storage sample application that uses the JavaScript client library for Google APIs. The Google JavaScript client library provides access from the JavaScript environment to cloud storage and many other Google APIs. Just add the script tag you see here to your HTML to include the Google JavaScript API client library. Now that you know how to include the JavaScript client library in your HTML, the next thing to do is to grab the code for the cloud storage JavaScript sample application. Since the source control for the sample's code is using git, the checkout command is git clone and then the name of the GitHub repository. The next thing you want to do is navigate into the directory containing the JavaScript sample code. Just copy and paste that cd command into your terminal. Then you'll want to follow through the README and enter the details in the index.html file. That will include your Google Cloud Storage project ID, your client ID, and your API key. After that, you can load it up on a web server and see it in action. A quick way to start a simple web server to view the demo is by using Python's built-in server. So let's switch over to a terminal window and try it out. You can see that I'm in the storage-getting-started-javascript directory. And if we list the files there, you can see the index.html file, which I've already updated to include my application's details. To start serving index.html from a web server, we can simply type Python-m SimpleHTTPServer. There, now the Python web server is running. Notice that the default port that it is serving pages from is 8000. So we can open up a browser and enter http://localhost:8000 to load the sample. Here's the cloud storage sample application using the JavaScript client library. If this is your first time signing in, you'll see an authorize button in the top left corner of the screen. And when you click that button, it will request permission to access your cloud storage resources. When you click accept and complete the authorization process, you can try out a sample API call. Let's start by listing all the buckets that are currently available for my project in cloud storage. So this sample application returns a few pieces of information, including an explanation of the selected API request, a bit of code that's generated for the request, and the API's response to the request we made. So if we look at the explanation, we can see that we're querying the Google Cloud Storage API for a list of buckets and returning that list. Looking at the code, you can see how we construct our parameter object and initialize a single parameter to that, which is then passed to the Google Cloud Storage API. Looking at the API response, which is formatted in JSON, we can see we're getting back a list of buckets, but we don't currently have any buckets in there, so let's go ahead and insert a bucket. Here's a bit of information about the request. Here's the JavaScript code that you can copy and paste directly into your code. Notice that we specified code sample test bucket as the ID of the bucket to be inserted. And here's the API's response. Now let's go back to list buckets to make sure that we actually inserted that bucket. And indeed, we can see that our items array now has one bucket, and the ID of that bucket is code sample test bucket. Excellent. We can do more than just list and insert buckets. We can also list a bucket's access control list, we can list and insert objects, and more. This sample is showing a subset of all the API commands available to help you understand the look and feel of making a JavaScript request to the Google Cloud Storage API. Check out the Cloud Storage documentation for the full list of commands. Now, why don't we take a look at the code so we can really understand what the request looks like in JavaScript? So if we open up index.html in an editor and look up a function like listBuckets, that's all there is to it. You can see we put together a request and we pass in the project ID for the project that we'd like to list buckets for, and then we execute the request. Looking at the execute request function, you can see it accepts two arguments, a request object and the name of the API request being made. Stepping into the function, first we execute the request, and then using a JavaScript function literal, we output the response to the HTML page, which you can see by jumping down into the function. We create HTML pre-element, and then we output the response to the inner HTML of that pre-element using JSON stringify. And then finally, we append that pre-element to a div element that's visible on the HTML page. Let's review the workflow for using the JavaScript client library. The first thing you'll do is include the Google JavaScript APIs. Just script that source, then you can include or load the Google API of your choice. Here we're including the Cloud Storage API. And finally, you can make requests and display responses. It's as easy as that. To wrap up, here are a few more resources where you can go to learn more. If you have any questions or feedback, please feel free to reach out to us on Stack Overflow or via email. Thank you for watching. Now that you've seen how easy it is to get started, go ahead and try out the Cloud Storage JavaScript sample for yourself.